mean, obviously, Vi's been playing through pain. What was your reaction then when you heard that he was going to have to miss some time?
You know, it was hurt. But, you know, we all got to step up and, you know, play to the best of our ability. That was a great loss, but, you know, we all have to mature now.
What's your expectation for what this means for you carry-wise between you and Steven going forward?
You know, we're just going to do what the coaches asked us to do. And whatever they want us to do, we'll do it to the best of our ability, along with Keenan and Quincy.
You see it as an opportunity, though, to prove yourself?
Yeah, I see it as an opportunity, but, again, we just got to, you know, step up and play even better now.
Obviously, the physical runs, the ones where you extend plays, it gets everyone talking. When you evaluate your game, what's the area where you still feel you have to grow the most?
That tackle in space when 14 had on me. You know, I could have made my move closer up to him instead of 10 yards back. So more making, like, getting up on somebody's toes and then making a cut instead of, you know, making a move 10 yards back. Because, in my opinion, there's no way he should be able to tackle me one-on-one. So I got to work on that and be able to break those tackles at the second level.
Do you see yourself as a running back who might get a little bit better even as you get more into rhythm, more carries?
I think that's any running back. The more carries any running back gets, the better rhythm they get, because it's a better feel for the game, the more they get warmed up.
Do you see yourself in a situation where, like, Tony Jones got 25 carries? Can you – you're a guy that could get to that place?
Whatever the coaches give me, I think I'll be able to handle it. But like I said, you know, we're all going to have to step up, so, yeah.
I'm pretty sure last year USC had its best rushing game against Arizona. What do you see in this matchup in terms of what you guys can do on the ground?
They have some great linebackers. Yeah, I get them blocked. I have faith in the O-line. They're going to be able to open it up like they've been doing all season, which makes our job a lot easier. All we got to do is make a few guys miss. So, like, I think we can do pretty good.
Has there been a tangible difference you noticed the last two games in terms of the blocking and the holes they're creating and what's been there for you?
I think we just gotten better as the season progressed. Like any team, the more games, the more experience the players get, and the better, more running. So, yeah.
Harold mentioned a good recovery thing that he'd like you to kind of improve in. He mentioned, like, the way you're carrying the ball to protect it, even though you haven't fumbled, but just, I guess, the way you hold it. Are those things that you're kind of working on?
Yeah, because I may not fumble right now, but if I continue to carry like that, it could lead to that. And that's something you don't want to do. The number one thing as a running back is to protect the ball. So if you put the ball on the ground, you can't be trusted. So that's definitely something I want to work on.
What did you get hard at all out there with that much work? Did you get kind of winded at all a little bit?
Like I said, after the game, you know, you're carrying a lot of people. You'll get winded. I think that's any running back. Nobody's Superman. So, yeah, I was
the one. One more.
Oh, what have you got you're doing that you kind of want to, like, correct or in terms of the way you carry the ball?
Just holding it high and tight, not switching it in traffic, because that's something I did, and it was as a liability. So you don't want to be considered a liability on the field.
Thank you, Marquis.